KGF, I'd like to invite the makers and of course the cast of the film to start up with two really cool people, Ritesh Sidhwani and Farhan Akhtar of XL Entertainment. If you could join me on stage, please. Aye, aye. Applause, applause, ladies and gentlemen. Yes, very good, sir. Hi, Farhan. Hi, very good. Now I'd like to invite, of course, the gentleman here with a really cool beard, if I might add. Ladies and gentlemen, Yash! And the debutante who's been here, by the way, on time, she's been here for a while now, Srinidhi Shetty. And the gentleman who's put this entire epic together from Ombole Films, we've got Mr. Vijay. Vijay, sir, where are you? Please. Okay, so ladies and gentlemen, the makers and the cast of this epic called KGF. I'll start with Ritesh first. Ritesh, 2001, the first film that XL did, Dil Chahta Hai, cult, legendary. 17 years, and now it's the beginning of something again where you ventured into a different language. You're presenting a film which was actually originally in a different language. What were the challenges and how excited were you to get on board with this project?
Good afternoon. First of all, sorry we were late. It was some technical stuff which was happening for the trailer. But I think the first step, I don't know where the person is, Mr. India, who's missing today is Anil Thadani, who's the one who first called us up and told us about the film. And the first thing was we watched the movie. And as soon as we saw it, we thought exactly what you hopefully you all will feel when you all watch the film, that this team here, which is Vijay, with Yash and Prashant, the director, who's also missing today, they had made a wonderful film. And we thought it lent itself to a big screen, like an entertainment, and it seemed like an event film. It was a perfect film for which we thought is the right time if we were trying to look at, you know, expanding the boundaries, going into the regional markets. And I think today we are constantly feeling that, you know, growing our market by going to China and other countries, and, you know, since language is not a barrier for us anymore, and trying to go, why not try to, you know, bring in films and within our own region. So I think that was the first thought. And like I said, it's a great film. It lends itself to a big screen entertainment. So we thought it's the right film to go with.
Farhan, XL, right from the beginning, I've already mentioned the film Dil Chahta Hai, but you've always been at the forefront of content-driven films. Like, you talk of your recent releases like Gold or Fukre, Rais, Zindagi Na Milegi Dobara, Dil Dhadakne Do. Farhan, do you think, as a country now, we keep saying the Indian movie industry, so many different languages, movies are being produced. Do you think as a country now, we have reached that point where the language of the story is not important, but the story in itself?
Yeah, I couldn't agree more. I think barriers are kind of falling down every single day. The world is becoming a smaller place. We are all enjoying work from cultures and from languages that we weren't very familiar with many years ago. And I think apart from what's happening in film, I think the whole digital revolution has a huge part to play in that, because we're consuming content now, with whether it's subtitled or it's dubbed, you know, in our homes, and we're getting more and more comfortable with just connecting with what it's about, as opposed to finding some amount of resistance because it's not in a language that you're familiar with. So I think that has helped. And eventually, filmmaking is about storytelling, and the story of KGF is very, very strong. It's visually very, very exciting. I've got very inspired. I'm trying to grow my beard like Yash. Hopefully someday I'll get there. But it really is an honor, you know, and when you were calling us up onto stage, I really would like to clarify that Ritesh, me, of course, are presenters for this film. I mean, these people are the makers and the cast, and we're very honored to be a part of it and present it to a Hindi-speaking audience.
Hello, Yash.
Hi.
Been watching a lot of Hindi films lately?
I've been watching since my childhood.
Amazing. And now you have a film which is coming out for this big audience. I was watching an interview recently where you were very clear and you kept saying this, that you are not trying to become a Hindi movie hero, right? But you thought that this film, if it is also in the Hindi language, it reaches a wider audience. If I had to talk of audiences, down in the Kannada film industry and maybe in the Hindi film industry. Do you see any difference in the audiences and what they consume?
No, I don't see much of a difference. Audience are same everywhere. They're very honest. If they like something, they like it, irrespective of your previous records. If they don't like, they'll kick you out of theater. They're very honest. I think it's same everywhere.
Srinidhi.
Hi.
She's got a story, man. From the field of engineering to a corporate job with a company called Accenture to now making it here in the movies. I mean, where did the switch happen? You've been into pageants also, if I'm not wrong.
Yeah. So, the desire to be part of this industry, entertainment industry, was there since my childhood. It's just that parents were very strict enough that you have to finish your education and you have to do something which they seem is right.
Been there.
So, yeah. So, for their happiness, I was like, chalo, karte kuch to engineering kiya and then get into a corporate company. But then I made sure that, you know, try getting out somehow and then sneaked into modeling and now I'm here. By God's grace.
No, sir? Okay. Very simple. Okay, ladies and gentlemen, I think we should now show the trailer to this wonderful media that is present here. And of course, they've all got their cameras out. So if you could take your seats, ladies and gentlemen. All right. I could actually see a lot of people cheering here while the trailer was going on. If you could just, yes. This giant. Guys, just be careful. This prop is not used in the film, I believe, for sure. Now we made this pretty comfortable for you guys to join us. So once again, Yash, Srinidhi, Vijay sir, Ritesh, Farhan. I'm sure the media has a lot of questions. Okay, so this is chapter one, which means it's a two-part epic. So I'm sure we have questions, but I'll start with Yash first. I have a question to ask. Yash, it doesn't look like a film that would have been easy while shooting, right? Especially during, the mining shots that you must have definitely shot for. How difficult was it on set to just be there around all this muck that is flying around, man?
It was very difficult. That was the most difficult part of the film. Because that's a processed sand, processed soil. They use, cyanide to process gold, I believe. So that was a dump yard of that. And a lot of people told us it is not safe to shoot there. But still, it was very tempting for us to shoot because the location was as such. It was very... very nice, suitable for our film. Then we went there and we all stayed there for months together. And then for every shot, if you notice, there's a lot of dust in it. And we didn't get artificial dust. It was using, we used compressor and it was the same thing. So, but we were very strong and because of the conviction, I think nothing happened.
Farhan, there is a part of the underworld also, and I remember that interview where Yash mentioned that this is not just about the underworld, this is not just about... But somehow, the underworld has always been a great content idea for a lot of films, right? Do you, when you were watching the trailer while everybody else was watching it, do you think the underworld is something which elicits emotion when it comes to the content of a film?
No, I mean, I really don't think of it as in that terms. I feel with every film, there's a certain USP, there's a certain draw. And in this film, like I said, the story of this one character, what he's out to achieve, is very, very strong. You get a sense of almost like a promise that this child is making his mother in the beginning of the film, of what he's going to be and what he's going to do. And it really follows his journey and his path. And that is really something that drives the film. So everything else that comes with it is actually from a place which is of pure emotion and of pure love. So that's it. That to me is the driving force of the film. Everything else, I mean, of course, is a lot of fun to watch. Like you can see, there's amazing action going on. There's a lot of humor in it as well. There's that one moment where he breaks this guy's arm and then uses his arm to push his hair back. So things like that. It's got all that going on, but at the heart of it, there's a very, very strong emotional connect that this character has with this promise that he's made his mother.
All right, my friends from the media, I'm sure you have questions, so please, this is your opportunity. Shoot. There's this one lady who is just interested in clicking a picture.
Center, sir. Rahul, the filmy chacha. Hello. Mera sawal Farhan sir se hai. Sir, South ki lagbhag sari filmein apni jagah blockbuster hoti hai, sir. Sab mein content hote hain. टर्न एंड ट्विस्ट होते हैं फिर उन सारी फिल्मों में से केजीएफ को चुनना हिंदी में डब करना फिर रिलीज करना तो आपने केजीएफ को ही क्यों चुना क्या ऐसा लगा इसका
सर एक तो मैं आपको थोड़ा क्लैरिटी दे दूं कि कभी कभी होता है कि आप स्क्रिप्ट चुनते हैं कभी कभी ऐसा होता है कि फिल्म आपको चुनती है तो इसमें जो हुआ है एक्चुअली जो अनिल थडानी जो आज यहाँ आई डोंट नो वेयर ही इज बट उन्होंने हमें कॉन्टैक्ट किया कहा कि एक फिल्म है आप देख लीजिए मुझे लगता है आपको पसंद आएगी और अगर पसंद आई तो we would like for you to present it. So both Ritesh and me saw some visuals from the film. We found out about the film. And it sounded like a very, very exciting project to be part of. And all I can say is that we are truly happy that we are associated with this film. And this probably then is a first step. You know, hopefully through this experience, there will be more people who want to reach out to us and maybe get their films presented. And that will be based on each film as it comes and what we feel of that film. With this film, it felt like the right thing to do, and that's why we're here today.
Hi, this is Sohail here on your left. You're on the first row. Congratulations to the entire team of KGF. Farhand, hum aapko miss kar rahe hain on the screen as well as direction-wise. Soon we'll see you, actually. Mera kehna tha ke in dino, lots of production houses are, you know, looking towards South, actually. Jis tarah ki filmein, matlab hai, Hindi mein dub ho rahi hai. How do you see the entire like, scenario at this point, particular point of time?
Sir, aapka sawal kiski taraf hai?
Aapki taraf, yeah.
Farhan ki taraf. Haan,
yeah. Okay. Yaar, you know, it's very difficult for me to comment on why other people do things they do. I just feel that at XL for the last 17, 18 years, we've been making films that we believe in. And similarly, as an extension of that, when there is something that we can associate ourselves with, that we feel would be a pleasure to associate with. It's some entertainment that we can provide an audience and or help reach an audience. That is something that we are interested in. We want to entertain people. We want to engage with people through film. And this is another opportunity to do that. I don't look at it as south, north, east, west. I don't think of it like that. Movies and storytelling, like we discussed earlier, it's changing. The demographics of audiences are changing. The way content is consumed is changing. And we are at a very interesting time, you know, where we are fortunate that we can share each other's work in each other's states or cultures or in different regions. And to be a part of that truly is a very, it's an honor actually to be a part of it.
There was a question coming.
Yash, my question to you. Yash.
Yash,
hi.
Yeah. Have you dubbed it in Hindi?
No, I haven't. I think I still have to work on my Hindi because... Just to prove that I'm a hard-working actor, if I go and dub, I don't want to ruin my film because I really love my film. But soon I'll be able to dub because I think a lot of people are telling my Hindi is improving. So very soon I'll be there.
I agree with
that. Do you like someone else mouthing your dialogues?
To be honest with you, no. As an actor, I would always want to dub for my own films. But I think... Nobody is bigger than cinema. When it comes to cinema, the cinema has to come out well. It has to do well. It has to entertain people. So if I come out and start dubbing in a bad Hindi, that will hamper the movie. So which I don't want it to happen.
Farhan, my question to you is, we've been seeing you producing films and associating. When will we see you acting and directing as well? Very soon?
I'm just finishing a film with Sonali Bose called The Sky is Pink. It's almost done. So you'll see that at some point mid next year. And beyond that, we'll discuss on some other forum. Right now, we are here to talk about KGF, if that's okay with you.
Yeah. Farhan, towards your left, in the front row. Hi.
Front row.
This is Priyanka from PTI. Farhan, I wanted to know that, you know, a lot of these South filmmakers have great vision, you know, and the way they tell their stories, it's always on a huge canvas. Be it this, be it KGF, be it Bahubali or 2.0 as well. But when it comes to Bollywood filmmakers, I feel that, you know, we don't have that vision. And what stops us from dreaming big or planning big? That's something I wanted to know from you.
I don't know if that's entirely true. I mean, we've taken the name of 3 films. You know, I'm sure there are many other films made in the South that we are not aware of or are smaller in terms of drama films or intimate films or personal films. These are the ones that excite people across the country to maybe want to watch because of the visual scale, you know, of them. And similarly, I mean, we have filmmakers. I think somebody like a Sanjay Leela Bansali, for example, is somebody who makes very, very epic visual films. So we do have filmmakers like that. But every industry and every, I guess, culture has its own strengths. And it's important to play to those strengths, you know, and you will learn as you go along and you will evolve. But I think that's really what it is, you know, and the ones that translate, similarly with American films, when they come here, the ones that usually end up registering are the big, you know, kind of superhero movies or stuff like that, because it's easier for people to go and understand what's going on. You know, it's, I think that's probably it.
Hello. Yash?
Which side, sir? If you could just raise your hand.
Right side.
There, okay.
Hi, Yash. Many congratulations for Baby Girl.
Okay, thank you. Thank you very much.
यश हमने देखा था कि बाहुबली 2 चैप्टर्स में बने हुए हैं तो फर्स्ट चैप्टर जब खत्म होता है तो सभी के दिमाग में ये सवाल आता है कि कटप्पा ने बाहुबली को क्यों मारा उसी तरह चैप्टर 1 में भी क्या ऐसा ही कुछ होगा जो दूसरी फिल्म की तरफ हमें ले जाएगा
आर यू किलिंग समवन एट द एंड ऑफ द फर्स्ट चैप्टर
नो ऐसे उस वजह से फिल्म चली वो नहीं कह सकते एंड इवन आई डोंट थिंक डायरेक्टर वुड हैव depended on that one particular point. Agar film achhi hai, to chalegi. Aur last mein, of course, yes, we have to have something which will, you know, get the audience for the second part. Waise hai, har series pe, serial mein bhi hota hai. Next episode dekhne ke liye, waise hai kuch karna padta hai audience ko. So, in this film also, there is something like that, but I cannot compare it to Kattappa because there is no Kattappa in our film.
Okay.
One question. Since we're talking of the chapter, right, the first chapter, is there a question on how much time should pass after the first chapter that the second chapter should release? Like, is there ever a time like that? Okay, we have to release it.
No, see, nothing goes according to the plan in cinema. Yeah. Even our first part has taken much more time than what we expected. So, I don't know, it all depends on my director who is missing today. He is a perfectionist. He's a wonderful director. It's all his work. He's missing today. In Bombay, it's me who is coming and talking about on behalf of him. But I think he's the man who has created this, Mr. Prashant Neel. He takes its own time. He takes his own sweet time. Even today he was supposed to come, but he's still working on the film. He says, it's your this thing. Please, you take care of that responsibility. I'll work. I'll make it better. So I cannot tell you that how much time we'll take, but we want to come very soon because everything is ready. The script is ready. We just have to go there, shoot, and come and release.
I'm sorry, ma'am. He was in the middle of asking a question.
Farhan sir, ek interview mein Yash ne kaha tha ka, unhone kaha tha ki ye kisi Hindi film mein kaam karna chahte hain. Aur to isi par main aapse sawal karna chahta hu ki. Would you like to direct a movie with Yash in future?
Okay, now we've gone one step further. First, I was asked, would you like to direct a movie only? Yeah, I whatever little you know of me, I mean, of course, he's a very, very talented
KGF is an audition.
Wow. He's, from what I've seen of his work, he's a very, very talented, very gifted actor. He's got great presence on screen. That was one of the first things I told him after I saw the film. So absolutely, I mean, the thing is that when you write something and when you know, casting kind of almost creates itself for the lead characters when you're writing something. So if something does come along, he's working on his Hindi already, so everything is coming together well. But yes, absolutely. I mean, if there is an opportunity, there's no reason why not to do it.
We are taking Farhan sir to Kannada.
Hi, Ritesh and Farhan. Runa from Web Duniya. आप दोनों से एक बात मैं जानना चाहती हूँ. जब भी आपकी फिल्म्स बनती है अलग अलग लैंग्वेजेस में, तो क्या दिक्कत होती है और आपको क्या चीज़ का ध्यान रखना पड़ता है और क्या चीज़ आसान हो जाती है आपके लिए?
Are you recording yourself asking us this question?
Yes, that's my way. So, आप दोनों में से जो दोनों का ही जवाब चाहिए था मुझे.
Sorry, your question is that what is the difficulty or what is makes it?
Language.
In language, yeah. I think, like you know, like I said earlier, I don't think language is a barrier anymore. We've, I think, gone beyond that. As long as the story is engaging, it's an audio-visual medium. On any level, if you emotionally connect and there is some connect to the story, you'll get it. I mean, I don't know if you've tried. I tried actually watching the first few minutes of this film the first time. Jab Anil leke aaya tha, there was no subtitle and there wasn't even a dub in Hindi, and I could understand the story of it. So I think that was something which I understood, that in the 7 minutes I saw, if I could relate and get the world and understand and have some connect with it, it obviously held me. And I think that itself is a big strength, that if the movie can, you know, engage you and can get your attention and you can feel it even without knowing the language, I think it makes it easier. And I think again, then marketing it or positioning it to an audience even here, I think of late we've seen films which have been dubbed, they've done extremely well. But I think again on that level, as long as the film connects with you, you identify with it, you relate with it, I don't think there is an obstacle there beyond that. You know?
I'm actually completely in agreement with what he said. I'll probably just end up repeating his words.
Yash, you're on the first row, on your towards your right.
Hi.
Left, sorry. KGF, this title might be a little difficult to, you know, come up with actually. I feel it like that. I don't know how easy or difficult it was, because initials khali hai.
No, it is Kolar Goldfields.
Yeah, I know.
So it's known as KGF there. And it is a very famous gold mine in our country. So, zyadatar log ko pata hi hoga. If not, then we'll educate them that there is a gold mine in Karnataka, which is called KGF. That was our intention. And the story revolves around the gold mine. So, we thought that is a perfect title for our film.
So, I think you can speak quite good Hindi. In fact, like, you can always try on the platform.
Sorry?
आप हिंदी अच्छी बोलते हो, हिंदी में ही बोलो. I think.
See, the problem is अच्छी बोलते हो या अच्छी बोलती है, those things confuse me. So, फिर भी I can talk. That's the only thing. Sometimes I address girls like that's the confusing part, because language sometimes, no, it can, if it goes wrong, कुछ भी हो सकता है यार, डर है. Especially talking to girls.
आप खुश हुए? इनके जवाब से?
या
सुपर.
हाय यश.
एक सेकंड, एक सवाल इधर से आ रहा है. यस मैम.
हाय, निकिता हियर फ्रॉम जून. एक्चुअली माय क्वेश्चन इज टू फरहान एंड रितेश. यू आर ऑब्वियसली क्लैशिंग विद योर जीरो एज वेल विद शाहरुख. सो यू नो, व्हेन इट कम्स टू स्क्रीन प्रेजेंस, जीरो हैज ऑलरेडी यू नो टॉक टू अ लॉट ऑफ डिस्ट्रीब्यूटर्स एंड विद say multiplexes as well, you know, to gather the screen space. How are you going to fight it? Because obviously Zero is quite a big film, is a friend of yours as well. To gather that screen space and to make sure that you get the amount of presence to match up to a film as big as Zero, what's your plan as to that?
And that's the kind of question I flunked in school.
Okay, so I think first of all, you know, I think ye sawal kafi time pehle bhi, many times films have released together. I don't think it's a clash or a fight or anything. There's enough space. This is, in terms of Zero, is for us the reason to go with this date was purely coming in from Vijay, Yash, Prashant when they came and met us. I think it's a very important date for them, for the South, and they're releasing the film not only in Kannada and in total four South Indian languages total. So it was the most apt. We couldn't have delayed it over here, and I don't think we are aiming to go as wide in the North Indian market as what I'm sure Zero will go with. So it's not going to be any clash, and in fact the screens can be shared. There is enough screen space. We've seen two Hindi movies released on the same day and both do very well. And it's a festive season in terms of the entire Christmas, New Year's time. Is there's enough space for films. So I think both will happen, and we're not aiming to go that wide as Zero. So that's not the intention, to go in the Hindi belt as.
How much screens you're getting
We haven't decided that. Anil, as he's missing, that is why I wanted him here to answer these relevant questions. I don't think we've thought about it right now, but definitely not as wide as 2.0.
Hi, Yash. This is Amit here from Chennai Speaks. Here.
Okay, hi, Amit.
Hi. I have heard that, you know, you have started a foundation with your wife called Yasho Marga Foundation. Can you just throw some light on it?
That's something, I don't know, it just started. One day I was watching a few, you know, news about drought. There was a drought situation in our state. That's when I decided if I can do something. Then I distributed water to 250 villages for over one and a half months through tankers. And then I've regenerated a 100-acre lake. That's something which I've done. It is not like a foundation which is completely working, but whenever I feel if I could do something or if I can help somebody, I do it through that foundation.
So this is your chapter one for this foundation.
Yeah, that's true. I have much more plans.
Srinidhi, hi. Rahul here from the Filmi Charcha. मेरा सवाल आपसे ये है कि KGF आपकी डेब्यू मूवी है, ये क्या प्रोसेस था, आपकी एंट्री कैसी हुई KGF में, ऑडिशन देने पर ही या क्या प्रोसेस था, प्रोसेस बताइए।
जी तो मैं 2016 में मिस इंडिया में पार्टिसिपेट मैंने किया था और उसमें मैं फर्स्ट रनर अप आई, तो जब वो ख़त्म हो गया तो शायद सारे पेपर्स में मेरे पिक्चर आए हुए थे और KGF टीम से लकीली उन लोगों ने मेरा पिक्चर देखा एंड दे अरेंज्ड फॉर अ मीटिंग और मैं मीटिंग में चली गई और बाय गॉड्स ग्रेस सब अच्छा से वर्क हुआ एंड दैट्स द वे आई गॉट इनटू दिस प्रोजेक्ट सो दे सॉ माय पिक्चर्स एंड देन वी हैड अ मीटिंग एंड उसके बाद उनको अच्छी लगी मैं फिर हो गया अब मैं यहाँ पे हूँ
दे मे हैव ऑडिशनड यू नो हेलो दिस साइड दे मे हैव ऑडिशनड यू
सो या
हाउ मेनी ऑडिशनड एंड इन व्हिच ऑडिशन यू क्लियर्ड एंड व्हाट वाज दैट वन थिंग द डायरेक्टर मे हैव लाइक्ड
सो तो ये हुआ कि सिर्फ एक मीटिंग में मुझे दे कॉल्ड मी फॉर अ मीटिंग एंड देयर वाज जस्ट वन मीटिंग सो वी मेट एंड दे गेव मी वन लाइन और टू लाइंस टू टेल तो मैंने मुझे लगता है बहुत बेकार किया था मैंने तो मुझे लगा कि ये कॉल वापस नहीं आने वाला है तो मैंने वो हो गया एंड देन आई वेंट बैक टू यू नो नॉर्मल रूटीन एंड आई थिंक अ फ्यू वीक्स लेटर आई गॉट अ कॉल दैट यू आर ऑन बोर्ड सो
हाउ
मैम आई एम वेरी फैसिनेटेड बाय योर एम्फेसिस ऑन डिटेल्स
गोल्ड से कितना मोह है आपको
थोड़ा भी नहीं देखो मैंने मैंने गोल्ड कुछ पहना ही नहीं है अभी
ओके वी आर गोइंग टू टेक टू मोर क्वेश्चंस सो ओके वी हैव थ्री हैंड्स रेज सो यस अमरप्रीत यू कुड आस्क अ क्वेश्चन
थैंक यू फॉर इंट्रोड्यूसिंग मिस रेन हाय दिस इज अमरप्रीत फ्रॉम वायरल बॉलीवुड यश कांग्रेचुलेशंस एंड टू ऑल द मेकर्स इट्स अ ब्रिलियंट ट्रेलर एंड आई एम वेरी श्योर दिस इज गोना बी अ ब्लॉकबस्टर
थैंक यू
यश Can you throw some light on your character? Is it inspired? Is it a fictional character, first of all?
Yes, it is fictional. It is a very unique character. He has a purpose in life. He is a very ambitious guy, very strong-headed and very aggressive, who would have gone through a lot of hardship in his childhood. So he has a promise to keep up. So that's what we showed in this trailer, where you know his mother asks him to be. Rich person, the most powerful person in the world. So he is trying to be a very powerful person in the world, and for that he needs to, you know, go to the most powerful place, and which is KGF at that point of time.
So was there an inspiration behind you know this character? किसी से आपने inspiration ली हो? थोड़ा थोड़ा हमें झलक भी मिल रही है जो angry young man का character देखते थे हम 70s 80s में अमिताभ सर का. So कहीं को कौन आपको ऐसा inspire करता है? Maybe your favorite actor?
नहीं सबका सबसे ले लेता हूँ मैं कुछ अच्छी चीज़ If I see, you know, some actor performing well, if I like something, I'll definitely adapt it because it is not like, you know, they say you have to learn with your experience and with your mistake. But I feel you have to learn with others' mistake and, you know, that's when you can learn more. So, truly, we are inspired by a lot of 70s, 80s Hindi films. Of course, Amit Ji's films and Salim Javed Saab's, a lot of films we love. That influence there. But it is partially it is influenced. But later, I think, अरे हो जाता है यार एक्टर होने से कुछ ना कुछ ऐसे बॉडी लैंग्वेज और
सब सबसे सीख लो कुछ ना कुछ
सबसे सीखते हैं और अपना कुछ over a period of time you'll also you know realize that this is what people will like and you will perform like that.
Thank you so much, sir.
Is the lady sitting? Yes, ma'am.
Hi, Farhan. This is a question to you. I wanted to know there was a movie called Kala Patthar, which was on coal mines.
So I think this movie will remind us of that. How much you see some inspiration from there? Because we reminded.
Right.
Because it's something.
No, ma'am, the stories
mind.
Are completely different. I mean, that film was about. It was actually that film.
Yeah.
If I remember clearly, there was.
Huge
star cast. Yeah, no, not only that. I mean, it was inspired from a true incident where there was a tragedy that had struck in a coal mine, and that had inspired Yash Ji and Salim Uncle and my father to write that script. So that really was a rescue film. Of course, there were emotional threads and all that, but it wasn't the kind of film that this movie is. They're very, very different. So I don't think there's anything that's going to remind you really of that movie through this.
And the last question coming from this lady, yes.
Obviously, the trailer looks great, but you know, unfortunately, I will have to digress a little bit. Your co-star from your next film, The Sky Is Pink, Priyanka, has just got married recently, and the pictures look lovely. We all from the media love her, love you, all of you. We want to also know what is the plan for your reception, because we've not got to know anything.
You're
Are you invited?
Wow.
Yes, we want to know from you.
It's like a mocha mil gaya,
yeah,
Farhan.
You know,
Farhan is here.
My wedding planner is still not on my resume. So I will know when you
invite.
Know. Ma'am, when you know, I will also know at the same time. Trust me.
You were just waiting, right?
Yeah, I want
last
to
question and
now,
I
so
will put this in. All right.
Yash, I have a question for you.
Yeah, please.
If this film becomes commercially very successful, so do we get to see you in Hindi films after that?
This is a Hindi film. See, that's what I was trying to tell, you know, in previous interviews as well. It is not like a Bollywood film or a Sandalwood film or a coming from Chennai or anywhere. It is just an Indian film. Language is not a barrier. See, I would want to tell a story in which you understand. So that's why I choose Hindi. And this dubbing is not like a regular dubbing film where we, you know, we just let it out and they dub it on their own. We have taken a lot of caution. We have worked on the lines. In fact, it has taken more work than the original thing. So this is something I feel I'm in indie industry already. So if I make a film which I feel has a universal appeal and even indie audience will love to watch it, definitely I'll do it. Otherwise, it's not like I want to enter Bollywood or something, because I'm happy with whatever people have given me. At the same time, this is happening because I need a wider audience. I want to reach my work to wider audience. That's Hindi language is one language which has got a lot of base, so that is the only reason. So let's see if something comes up where they can utilize my market, my existing market also, then yeah, I might.
Okay, I'm going to end this with one question to Ritesh, last question. Ritesh, we have spoken about languages and cultures. There was a time when the same story, like if I have to cite an example, Mani Ratnam sir would make a film in Tamil and then it would be completely adapted with a different cast and made in Hindi. Recently, that has completely changed, of course, with films like The Ghazi Attack, which is one of my favorite films that has come from the South. Do you think that formula is now over, where you have to adapt a film with a different cast? Now you can just take the original film, dub it in Hindi, and play it out for the market, not worrying about the kind of actors who are working in it, but the story has to be good.
No, I think both will continue to coexist. It can't be that there are films which will make an interesting adaptation, because you'll take the story and the core of it and then, you know, change around the screenplay and adapt it differently. And I think that will happen. Or you'll also see more and more films, which I don't think, you know, a film like this, which is literally a visual treat. It is a large screen entertainment which you come in and watch and experience. It's more like yesterday I was talking to Yash, this actually for me it becomes like an event film. Now for these kind of films, I think it lends itself very naturally and it is seems possible to be dubbed. And there are some films which you feel, okay, you can go beyond that and, you know, probably it is better to adapt. So I think it will all depend on each film, each script you come across.
Yash, last question.
Oh, man.
Bollywood gives you a wider, you know, global reach. So undeniably, if you bestowed upon a chance to work in Hindi films, which director would you choose to work with, to begin with?
These are slam book questions.
There are many. I love Rajkumar Hirani sir's work, Farhan sir's work, Anurag Kashyap's work. There are plenty of them. It all depends on the script, ma'am.
Okay, ladies and gentlemen, thank you so much for all the questions. And now I would request Ritesh, Vijay sir, Srinidhi, Yash and Farhan, if they could step in front of this beautiful prop for photographs of the media. We'll do a group.